We are East River 9 here in Houston, Texas. As you can see, we have the beautiful skyline behind us. I will be giving you guys a lesson on how to chip better and knock some strokes off your game. So I have my 60-degree wedge here. So what I want you guys to understand is the biggest mistake I see people make when they chip is they think that it's important to take the club all the way back and then they decel and it blades it over the green or you flub it. So what I want you to try to think about is you're hitting a long putt. So what you'll notice when you chip, and you can actually take your eyes and watch your hands, but what I want you to try to get comfortable doing is taking that club just past your waist, just past that pocket, and then you're just gonna follow through just past your waist and just past your pocket. So what you'll hear me say a lot of times is I just want you to go pocket to pocket, and then the club will do all the work for you. So if you can get that one basic chip down, the rest of the game is gonna become so much easier for you because all we do from there is we just change clubs. So as you can see, we're gonna go pocket to pocket, and that simple drill with that 60 degree is gonna look like this. So pocket to pocket. The ball hits and rolls to the flag. I don't have to do anything extra. What I do now is I switch golf clubs. So I also have my 52 degree here. So my 52 degree is going to land approximately in the same spot, but it's gonna roll out much more. So if you go to that next flag, and we do that same pocket to pocket, you're gonna see that it lands in about the same spot, but it rolled pin high to that next flag. What I didn't do is I didn't take it back farther, I didn't take it back shorter, I used that same technique and allowed the club and the degree on the wedge to do the difference. So I'm gonna pick up my 48 degree now, and I'm gonna use that same technique, and we're gonna go pocket to pocket. The ball lands on the green, and then we let that degree on the club do the rest of our work. I didn't take it back farther, I didn't take it back shorter, I just allowed the club and the degrees to do that work. So if I had a flag even farther, I could even take my 7-iron and let it land and roll to the hole to the other side of any green when you have a 100-foot chip. So what you're probably wondering is how do you decide which club to use when you're out here? So the best thing you can do is put a tee or a head cover out on the green and work on that solid pocket-to-pocket stroke. Land your 60, count it off. If you throw the 60 5 yards and it rolls out 3 yards, great. Then when you go on the course, you can use that same mathematical equation depending on the shot that you're using. If you take your pitching wedge and it lands 12 yards and rolls out 12 yards, then you can also use that same concept for that. But I would recommend putting a tee out on the green and just trying to land each club in that same spot and then see how far they roll out from there. You'll notice a very interesting pattern when you change clubs.